Hello student, in this video we are going to see our practical number 5, that is the turbidity of water. Okay, turbidity जिसे हम बोलते हैं पंकिल, okay, और मराठी में उसे गढ़ूलता, okay, that we are going to determine in this experiment. Okay, so turbidity of given water samples. Four water sample, unknown water samples are given to you and you have to determine its turbidity. Okay, and even knowing water, it is the important and useful compound for the industry also and for the survival of human being or any living thing, water is necessary. Okay, so whatever water you are going to consume for the domestic purpose, it should be the clear in appearance. Okay, so the domestic purpose or for drinking purpose, whatever the water we are using, it should have the turbidity less than 1 NTU. What is that NTU? It is the nephelometric turbidity unit. Okay, this is the unit of that turbidity. Okay, so जो भी हम पानी पीते हैं उसकी turbidity less than 1 NTU होनी चाहिए. Okay, तो practical significance, already you are having the manual, you can read it, where that water it is a wonderful, abundant, useful compound. Okay, and without that, just now I said to you, without that one can't survive. Okay, so means living things, plants also needed, animals also need the water. Okay, and industry also can't run without that water. Okay, and it is important in the steam generation. It is used as a coolant in power plants also, in chemical plants also. Other than its industrial applications, it is used in the steel, rayon, paper industry, atomic energy, okay, textile, chemicals, ice, air conditioning, drinking, bathing, sanitary, washing, everywhere water is needed. Okay, so turbidity, what it is going to cause? If we are going to use directly turbid water, what it is going to cause? It is going to cause the various problems. Okay, if we are going to use that turbid water in the textile industry, proper dyeing will not be happen. Okay, if we are going to use the turbid water for the dyeing to the thread or that cloths or yarn, it is not going to give you the perfect stain. Okay, so sometimes its color is faint and sometimes it is going to produce the dark patches because of that turbidity. Okay, so in textile also it is not good. In paper industry, in sugar industry also, the turbid water, it is not good. So we have to determine its turbidity by using the nephelometer. Okay, so relevant program outcomes. After completing this, you will be able to, you should have the basic knowledge. Basic knowledge means uses what is turbidity and how it is determined, which instrument is used to determine the turbidity, what are the various units of the turbidity, that all is going to get clear after completing this. Okay, experiment and practice. Okay, you must be able to plan and perform the experiment, and after performing the experiments you should be able to interpret the results what you are going to get. Okay, and from that result you have to solve the problems which is going to cause. Okay, now plan means here nephelometer is needed, water samples, various chemicals which are needed for this experiment you have to collect in the beginning, and then you have to perform the experiment. And whatever the results you are going to get, that you have to interpret. Okay, and when you are going to interpret that result, and from that you have to draw the conclusion whether it is suitable for drinking or whether it is suitable for textile industry or not. Okay, engineering tool. Okay, apply appropriate technologies and tools with understanding of limitation. Okay, means here in this experiment we are using the nephelometer, so under what condition, how to calibrate, what are its limitation, you must know all that. You must be able to handle, you must be safely you can operate. This skill means hand-on practice is needed for this. So which instrument or engineering tool we are going to use here? We are going to use here nephelometer. Okay, so it is also called turbidity meter. By using that we are going to determine the turbidity. Next, environment and sustainability. So what are the impact of that turbidity or that turbid water on societal and environmental context? how you are going to overcome that, how you are going to remove the turbidity, all that, you must have that knowledge. Individual and teamwork, you must be function effectively as an individual and as well as टीम मेंबर. आपको अकेले को भी करने को आना चाहिए और ग्रुप में भी आपको एक्सपेरिमेंट करने को आना चाहिए. लाइफ लॉन्ग लर्निंग. ओके, सो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू थिंक मोर एंड मोर, एवरी टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू से, व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू थिंक मोर एंड मोर, दैट टाइम दिस लाइफ लॉन्ग लर्निंग इज एबिलिटी इज डेवलप्ड इन यू पीपल. ओके, सो दिस इट इज नेसेसरी टू हैव द रिसर्च अप्रोच इन यू पीपल. Okay, so competencies and practical skills. After performing this practical, measurement skills, handling instrument and calibration skills are developed in you people. So course outcome, as it is related to the CO5, that is water treatment. So what is its CO, course outcome? Use relevant water treatment process to solve the industrial problem. Okay, this is the course outcome. And what is practical outcome? What you are going to do? Determine the turbidity of given sample by nephelometric method. Okay, here in this today's experiment, four samples are given to you and you have to determine its turbidity. By which method? By nephelometric method. Okay, next we will see the minimum theoretical background. As water is turbid, when it will become the turbid bole to jaise maine aapko bola marathi madhe tela kay mantat gadhulpana. ओके, व्हेन इट विल बिकम द टर्बिड, पंकिल बोलते हैं हिंदी में उसे, पंकिल बोलते हैं. इट इज नॉट क्लियर, कुछ तो ऐसे सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल्स रहते हैं उसमें. ओके, सो टर्बिडिटी में कॉज बाय फॉरेन मटेरियल्स लाइक अलगे, उसमें अलगे होते हैं, सैंड, क्ले होता है, सॉल्ट, केमिकल प्रेसिपिटेट और अदर ऑर्गेनिज्म की वजह से वो टर्बिड बनता है. इट इज नॉट क्लियर. ओके, व्हेन वॉटर बिकम स्टेशनरी बोले तो जब तक हम जैसे हमने सेडिमेंटेशन में देखा था, व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कीप द वॉटर विदाउट डिस्टर्बिंग इट फॉर द लॉन्ग टाइम, देन द लार्ज सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल्स दे आर गोइंग टू सेटल डाउन ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एंड लाइटर एंड फाइन पार्टिकल इट टेक्स द लॉन्ग टाइम टू सेटल डाउन. ओके, सो टर्बिडिटी इज अमाउंट ऑफ क्लाउडीनेस इन द वॉटर. जैसे क्लाउड जैसा दिखाई देता है, इट इज नॉट क्लियर, ऐसे अंदर दिखाई देता होगा आपको फ्लोटिंग, इसमें वॉटर में फ्लोट होता है, तैरते रहता है, अंदर रहता है. ओके, सो इट इज द क्लाउडीनेस, अमाउंट ऑफ क्लाउडीनेस इन द वॉटर. ओके, जनरली ग्राउंड वॉटर इज लेस टर्बिड ड्यू टू नेचुरल फिल्ट्रेशन. देखो ग्राउंड वॉटर आपको मालूम होगा, वेल का पानी ले लो, कुएं का पानी, तो इट इज लेस टर्बिड. बट जब भी आप कोई भी कौन सा भी लेक का वाटर लोगे या ओशियन का ले लोगे तो उसमें टर्बिडिटी ज्यादा रहती है. ओके, सो व्हाट आर द वेरियस यूनिट्स ऑफ द टर्बिडिटी? सी हियर, स्टैंडर्ड टर्बिडिटी यूनिट. स्टैंडर्ड टर्बिडिटी यूनिट क्या है? एमजी पर लीटर, और उसे ही हम क्या बोलते हैं? पीपीएम. अब तक जितने भी हमने एक्सपेरिमेंट किया था उसमें हमने देखा था एमजी पर लीटर और पीपीएम बोलते हैं उसे. जैक्सन टर्बिडिटी यूनिट जेटीयू, दिस इज द अनदर यूनिट ऑफ टर्बिडिटी. ओके, नेफेलोमेट्रिक टर्बिडिटी यूनिट NTU, दीज थ्री आर द यूनिट्स ऑफ टर्बिडिटी. ओके, WHO, वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सजेस्टेड दैट टर्बिडिटी ऑफ वाटर शुड बी लेस देन 1 NTU. जो भी हम पानी पीते हैं उसका टर्बिडिटी कितना होना चाहिए? इट शुड बी द लेस देन 1 NTU. ये देखिए यहाँ पे ऐसा इंस्ट्रूमेंट दिखाई देगा आपको, दिस द नेम ऑफ दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज द नेफेलोमीटर. ये जो इसे सेल बोलते हैं या कोवेट भी बोलते हैं, इसमें हमें सैंपल जो भी दिया है वो यहाँ पे लेना पड़ता है कोवेट में. ओके, और इसके बाद क्या क्या रिसोर्सेस लगने वाले आज के एक्सपेरिमेंट को? हमें नेफेलोमीटर लगेगा, वॉल्यूमेट्रिक फ्लास्क, प्लास्टिक और ग्लास बॉटल, उसे ही हम कोवेट बोलते हैं, बीकर, वेरियस केमिकल्स आर नीडेड. ओके, सो पहले हमें कैलिब्रेशन करके लेना पड़ता है और उसके बाद ही ये एक्सपेरिमेंट आपको उसके टर्बिडिटी, जो भी सैंपल है उसकी टर्बिडिटी डिटरमाइन करनी पड़ती है. ओके, सो लेट अस मूव टुवर्ड्स द प्रोसीजर पार्ट,
प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट. सो प्रोसीजर, इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू स्टेप. इन स्टेप वन वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर 400 NTU फॉर्मेजन स्टॉक सस्पेंशन. ओके, 400 नेफेलोमेट्रिक टर्बिडिटी यूनिट्स फॉर्मेजन स्टॉक सस्पेंशन वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर. सो फॉर दैट व्हाट वी हैव टू टेक? We have to take, see here, it is a, we have to dissolve 1 gram hydrazine sulfate in filtered water and that we have to dilute to 100 ml in volumetric flask. And after that, what we have to take? We have to take 10 gram of hexamethylene tetraamine. And it is also dissolved in filter water, and that we have to dilute to the 100 ml. So let us proceed for the procedure.
So this is our weighing balance, electronic weighing balance. Okay, now we are going to keep the weighing paper there and make the weight of paper to the zero, adjust it to the zero.
Make it zero by using the tear button. Now it is zero and it is stable. Here we have to take 1 gram of hydrogen sulfate. Okay, here you can see this is the bottle of hydrogen sulfate, and we have to take exactly 1 gram of this hydrogen sulfate.
It is more than 1 gram, so remove excess quantity. Few more we have to remove. Try to take exactly 1 gram. Now you can see here it is a 1 gram hydrogen sulfate, 001 gram is excess. You can see unit is 1 gram. Okay, is it visible to you? Okay, it is a 1 gram of hydrogen sulfate. Now what you have to do? Transfer this 1 gram hydrogen sulfate into the beaker and dissolve it in filtered water. Okay, this is our filtered distilled water, in that we are going to dissolve it. And after complete dissolution of that hydrogen sulfate, we have to dilute it up to the 100 mark using volumetric flask. This is our volumetric flask on which it is written that hydrogen sulfate. Okay. And first we are going to dilute it. Stir it now. Now this hydrogen sulfate is dissolved. Now we are going to transfer it into the 100 ml volumetric flask. Okay, dilute it using distilled water up to the mark. Yes, up to this marking. Is it visible? Up to the marking, it is your 100 ml. So here hydrogen sulfate 100 ml solution prepared. How it is prepared? 1 gram hydrogen sulfate powder. It is first dissolved in the beaker, and after that it is transferred to the 100 ml volumetric flask and diluted up to the mark to get the 100 ml of the hydrogen sulfate. Okay. Now we have to prepare hexamethylene tetraamine. Okay. For that same, here we are going to use tetraamine. We have to take the 10 gram of this hexamethylene, okay, 10 gram of that we have to weigh on the weighing balance. Take the 10 gram of here we have taken the 10 gram of
hexamethylene tetraamine. Okay, so approximately only 0.003 gram it is extra. Okay, now transfer this hexamethylene tetraamine into the beaker and dissolve it by using the filtered water. Again, same we have to dilute to the 100 ml like hydrazine sulfate, same like hydrazine sulfate. Only hydrazine sulfate 1 gram it is taken. Here hexamethylene tetraamine we have taken it 10 gram. After complete dissolution of this, you have to transfer this to the 100 ml volumetric flask. So after complete dissolution, transfer to the 100 ml volumetric flask. We are transferring it now. Okay, and remaining dilute it with the distilled water to make the volume 100 ml. Yes, here hexamethylene tetraamine solution is ready. Okay, and this is hydrazine sulfate, 100 ml of hydrazine sulfate, and this is the 100 ml of hexamethylene tetraamine. Okay, what we have to do, we have to take the 5 ml of this hydrazine sulfate and 5 ml of that hexamethylene tetraamine into the another 100 ml volumetric flask. Okay, and that mixture, 5 ml of hydrazine sulfate and 5 ml of hexamethylene tetraamine, this mixture 5 ml of both, we have to keep it for the 24 hour, and after 24 hour we have to dilute it to the 100 ml. So let us take the 5 ml of hydrazine sulfate. Madam, please take the 5 ml of hydrazine sulfate.
So adjust to the mark. Yes.
Yes. Now transfer this to the another 100 ml volumetric flask. This is 5 ml hydrazine sulfate. After that we have to take the 5 ml of hexamethylene tetraamine into the same volumetric flask. So this is the 5 ml of hexamethylene tetraamine. Adjust to the marking. To the bulb you have to suck and then adjust to the mark. Okay. Transfer to the same 100 ml volumetric flask where we have taken the 5 ml of hydrazine sulfate. Okay, now this mixture, 5 ml of hydrazine sulfate and 5 ml of hexamethylene tetraamine, that we have to keep for the 24 hour. After 24 hour we have to dilute it up to the 100 ml. Okay, and then we have to use this solution for the preparation of 100 NTU formazine stock solution. Okay, stock suspension. So okay, so here our mixture solution 24 hours is completed. Now here in this solution we have taken the 5 ml hydrogen sulfate and 5 ml hexamethylene tetraamine and kept for the 24 hours. Now we have to dilute this up to the mark to make the volume 100 ml. Yes, dilute this solution to the 100 ml. Okay, so this is our formazine stock suspension is ready. It is also called the reagent solution. Now what you have to do, we have to take the 25 ml of this stock suspension or reagent solution in 100 ml volumetric flask, okay, and dilute to 100 ml to make the 100 NTU standard solution. Yes, now it is the 25 ml. Transfer this to 100 ml volumetric flask and dilute it using the distilled water. It will make your 100 NTU standard solution. Yes, madam, dilute it with the distilled water to make the volume 100 ml. Yes, ready, which is used for the standardization or calibration of that nephalometer. Okay. Yes, now we will see the second part of this experiment, that is the determination of turbidity. Okay, this is the equipment which is used for the determination of turbidity. It is called the digital nephalometer. This is the digital nephalometer. Okay, here is the zero. This is the calibration knob. When your reading is between near about 20 NTU, that time you have to use this upper, and when it is you want to calibrate, that time it is kept to the 200 NTU. Okay, and this is the cuvette cell where you have to place this cuvette. Okay, or it is also called sample cell. Okay, you can see here is a one marking. Okay, vertical marking, vertical white line is there. How you are going to place this? You have to place this cuvette or sample cell into that nephalometer, which is exactly coinciding to that or perpendicular to that mark. Okay, so I just push it and close this cell. Okay, so in this way it is kept. Now first we will see how to calibrate this. Okay, and what is the principle of that nephalometer also. Okay, you can see there is a light, it is coming from the bottom. Okay, the source is used. Okay, if turbidity is there, it is going to absorb the radiation, and reading is changed here. Okay, so first we will do the calibration of this. Before to start the experiment, before half an hour this instrument is kept on. Okay, now here is our 100 NTU solution which we are going to use for the calibration. See, here knob is at the bottom up to the it is to the 200 NTU. Now place your cuvette or sample cell in the nephalometer. Okay, see how I am going to place, whether it is visible to you. Yes, that vertical line, it is exactly coinciding to that line which is on the instrument. Just press it, close that cell, and you have to use this calibration knob to make the reading 100. Okay, so adjust till your reading will get to the 100. Water cuvette, same like the previous one. Okay, close that cell and adjust to the zero. Okay, see here, and then by using this zero knob you have to make it zero. Okay, so that your nephalometer, it is calibrated. You have to make it zero. Okay, now your nephalometer, it is calibrated. Okay, okay, now here four samples are given. Four samples, that is sample number one, sample water sample we have taken, whose turbidity we have to determine. These four samples it is taken here, and you have to note down the readings of this. Okay, now ma'am, take the cuvette. Okay, and see how to handle that. Don't you? Yes, ma'am. Please bring it here. Use tissue paper while filling this cuvette or sample cell. If you are going to use directly by your finger, then your fingerprints, it is going to also absorb some radiation, and your reading will not get the you are not going to get the accurate reading. Okay, so this is the sample solution number one. Okay, place, remove this. Okay, place this sample solution number one into the nephelometer, close that cell and observe your reading. Okay, your first reading it is 0.30. So where to write this reading? We are going to write the reading in observation and calculation part, sample solution number one, and turbidity in NTU, it is our 0.32 NTU, it is the turbidity of sample solution number one. Okay, next, third column, it is the temperature of sample solution. We will record it later. Okay, first we will take all the turbidity reading. Now I'm take the next sample solution B. Okay, is it filled? Yes, remove that cell and place the sample solution 2 into the nephelometer. It is also called the turbidity meter. Okay, observe the reading. It is 0.0. It is changing. 0.05. Sample solution, it is 0.05. Fill the third cell, ma'am. Third sample solution. Okay. Third sample solution. Yes, our sample 3 is ready. Remove the sample 2. Place this. Close the cell properly. 0. Okay, so sample 3rd. So sample 3rd, it is 0.04. In sample solution number 4, it is kept there and its reading is 0. Now we will record the temperature of the sample solutions. Sample solution number 2.
30.
So temperature of the sample 2. So we are going to record it here. Sample number 2, 30 degrees Celsius. Sample 1.
32.
Okay. So write it in your manual. Sample number 1, it is 32 degrees Celsius. Next, sample 3.
32.
Again, sample 3 is also having the same temperature, 32. And record the sample 4, ma'am. Sample 4, the temperature of sample 4, it is
33.
So you have to write it here, 33 degree Celsius. Okay.
Yes. So our results are here in observation table. We have recorded the temperature also and the turbidity also, that is 0.32 NTU for the sample 1. Sample 2, it is 0.05 NTU. Sample 3, 0.04 NTU. And sample 4, it is 0.13 NTU. What is NTU? It is a nephelometric turbidity unit. Okay. And after that also, we have recorded the temperature of each solution. Sample 1, 2, 3, 4, which is 32 degree Celsius, 30 degree Celsius. Again, for sample 3, it is 32 degree Celsius. And sample 4, it is having 33 degree Celsius. Okay. So after that, you have to record your results. Results same here, whatever which you have recorded in the observation table. Okay, so sample 1, it is having 0.32 NTU. Sample 2, 0.05 NTU. Sample 3, 0.04 NTU. And the turbidity of sample 4, it is 0.13 NTU. If you are going to observe all these reading which you are recorded by using the nephelometer, which is less than 1 NTU, is it? Right? So all these readings, they are the less than 1 in TU. So, interpretation of result, you have to mention that all the sample contains turbidity less than 1 NTU. As you are knowing, according to WHO, World Health Organization, the water sample which consists less than 1 NTU turbidity, it is suitable for the drinking purpose. So, what is your conclusion? All these four samples, they are suitable for the drinking purpose. Hence, you have to write it like this. Hence, all the above samples are suitable for drinking purpose. Thank you. All this is for the experiment number 5, that is turbidity of water sample.